Robust. Powerful. Reliable. Already good. Can they be made even better? Can they be made stronger, smarter, more efficient? Maybe it's time to combine them with 21st century digital technology, creating a gateway through which we can deliver simplified design, easier installation, maximum productivity, minimum downtime. A gateway designed to give you easy access to new and higher standards, so you can make products smarter using exceptional technology. This is your gateway to interactive control and the digitalization of engineering. Your gateway to artificial intelligence and automation designed to raise performance. Take the gateway to your next performance level. Your gateway to connected hydraulics. Now, next, and beyond.
Good afternoon and welcome here from the heart of hydraulics in Lohr am Main. My name is Stefan Lehnert and I will be the host for the next 45 minutes to guide you through our web seminar concerning the hydraulic cylinders by mouse click. Today with me I have my colleague Frederick from Sweden. Hello Frederick.
Hello, nice to be here.
And we will talk about a specific, the first element of the connected hydraulics topics, simplify the engineering, and we will show how easy it will be to get these kind of products by a mouse click in some minutes. But before we will do that, I would like to tell you that it's not a presentation only what we are doing here. We want to do that interactive. That is why I would like to urge you to support us here. You see here on the screen the QR code that you can scan with your smartphone, or if you like, you can use your laptop and go to menti.com and using the code. So let's switch now to this page. I can show you a little bit how it works. We have prepared some questions for you. So, of course, the first warm-up question, I would really like to know where you're coming from right now. So we're here in Germany, in Lohr am Main. But I'm really looking forward to see where you're coming from. And there are some further questions, so please click them through during this web seminar. If you have questions for us or some remarks or hints, please use the Q&A, the question and answer section. This is the gray button that you will get with every question in the Mentimeter. And if you want to ask a question, you can write it down and we will see it then during the web seminar. We will have some time to always look to your questions. So feel free to support us here. And I would say let's go to the first answer already. So where you are coming from today. We know that we have now the afternoon session. So I think we have some people from Southern America, I see Brazil, at least Morocco and Germany in Europe, but also USA, the Netherlands, Portugal. Looks like we have all the guys here supporting us and participating. The second question would be, are you a machine builder or an end user? I see a tendency to have machine builders here, some Rexroth employees, and also a lot of partners today. Very good. Our CE partners are always very welcome. We're looking forward to give you some information. Then the third question about the industry sector. It's a broad range. Machine tools, presses, metallurgy, I see. Interesting, in the morning we had plastics. Now we don't have anybody from plastics here, so a good mix. And a lot votes for others. So please also write down in the QA section if you like what sector you're coming from. It's also interesting for us who is behind this lens that I'm talking to. And then the last question, what is your function, your role inside of the company? We have some salespeople here. We have people from service, a good amount of people from service here and from the design department. That's also a little different than in the morning. So let's see, I think for everybody is nice content, and now I would say switching to the topic, talking about configuration. I said it already, configurators are not that brand new. I think all of us have maybe configured our car, or like I said, from Sweden, I know the famous IKEA, where I configured my kitchen. So looking about these products, talking about these products, what is so specific with industrial cylinders concerning configuration?
The most important thing I would say is the variety of of options that we have in our products. Yeah, there are hundreds of thousands of different variations that you can order and configure directly online. And it's also a very, using this online configurator, it's also a very straightforward and smooth process to do so.
Okay, so let's start maybe then with the portfolio range. Mm-hmm. Maybe you can show our participants what's the offering here from Industrial Cylinders.
Absolutely. So basically we categorize our products into two different categories. We're talking about catalog cylinder, which is our focus today. We also have a product range, what we call application cylinder. That will not be our focus for this session. But including the application cylinder scope, we can do cylinders up to bore diameter, so 1.7 meters, and stroke lengths up to 18 meters. So that's quite substantial. But again, focusing on the catalog cylinders, which is basically the dark blue area in this overview, we can have a closer look to the product ranges, so the product portfolio. We have six different product ranges with our catalog products, and four out of those six are ISO conform, meaning that they are one-to-one replaceable with products from other companies according with the, where the cylinders is according to the same ISO standard. And what you also see in this overview is a go-to symbol on three out of these six series. Go-to in this case means that it's a focused delivery program. So that means we have a shorter delivery time on those products. And in the case of hydraulic cylinders, we're talking about 15 working days of delivery time.
So looking, I think you brought some examples here.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe you can go through it quite quickly. What type of cylinders do we see here?
Yeah, absolutely. I will do so. So basically, we have three different design principles, I would call it. Beginning with the smallest one that we see over here, that's a tie rod design, which is represented in our product portfolio by the cylinder series CDT3. The next one in the middle here is the welded design. That's a CDL2 cylinder series. And finally, we have the red cylinder over here, and that's the CDH1 cylinder range.
And we can directly see that there are some differences here, but they're all configurable.
They are all configurable, yes.
Okay, so talking about configurators at IH, it's a substantial part of the business here. Mm-hmm. I think in the back here, behind that wall, these cylinders are manufactured.
Yep.
So by the amount of cylinders that are produced, what would you say, what is the share of configured cylinders?
The share is around about 60%.
60%.
So it's quite high share.
More than half of them. And still we see already some variations also in color. I think we will have a look into that a little closer in a second.
Absolutely.
And when was the first configurator online? Is there something you
can
talk about?
Yeah, the first cylinder configurator was actually launched already 15 years ago. Of course, we have developed it more and more since then. So up to the state where we are currently, which is, I would say probably our online configurator today is state of the art on the market.
And we will see that, I think, in a second. So you prepared a live demo, but before we want to do that, let's go to your questions or the Q&A first. Let's have a look if there's some Q&A already. Yeah, there's the first question coming in. Can we get the presentation after the session? Of course, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we will send it with your email that you sent on the registration. You will get the presentation, including all the links to the tools that we will show.
Mm-hmm.
So, of course, you can do it. We will do that. And it looks like there's a second question also. Yeah. Very nice. So from the cement and the mining sector, we have also people. I think that's a typical range also for this type of product.
Definitely, yes.
So let's go to the other two questions that we have prepared. We talked about the colors already. So it looks like even more than half of the participants, they don't really have a specification here, or they don't want to focus on one, but it looks like the standard primer is kind of has a little more share.
Mm-hmm.
And there are some users that want to have special painting. So as I said, we will show that in a second. So let's switch maybe to a live demo. I think you have prepared something. I would like to give you tasks. I'm a UX guy. So I like to have some interaction here. I would like to urge you to do a configuration of this type of cylinder. Mm-hmm. Maybe we can start with the standard version.
Yep, so absolutely.
I think you said about the go-to and 15 working days of delivery. We will see how this will work. And then I want exactly that one in red.
Okay, absolutely. We'll do so. So a standard version of this one would be a blue one then, obviously. So let's start with that. And then we'll start by going to the Bosch Rexroth website, boschrexroth.com. And for language purposes, we will select not Germany today, but we will select United Kingdom, so that we get everything in English language.
But it's of course available in each individual website.
Yes, it's globally available.
Like in Brazil, we've seen, or in Morocco.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So we go to the local site of the United Kingdom, and then we end up on the landing page of Bosch Rexroth. And if we scroll down a little bit on that first page, we find the different product categories. And hydraulic cylinders is part of industrial hydraulics. So we make a selection there that we select the industrial hydraulic product portfolio. Again, some scrolling down, and then we have cylinders on the top left. So we'll select that one. And then basically we are already in the online configurator, and here we can select what kind of cylinder type that you would like to have. If you already know that you want a mill type cylinder, you can click here. If you want a tie rod cylinder, you have the possibility to click there. There are also some further options. If we click open here, that gives us a more detailed overview of the different cylinder series. So now we wanted to configure a CDH1, which is a mill type cylinder. So therefore we will step in here. Mm-hmm. And we know that this is the differential cylinder. It's not a double rod or a cylinder with a sensor inside. So that means we can go with a single rod cylinder. And here we have the CDH1 on top. If we scroll down, you see that the other cylinder series we have in the mill type category.
And they're all configurable, as we can see.
They are all configurable, yes. And you could also download data sheets and operation manuals already from this stage.
Mm-hmm. So let's start with the configurator.
Yep. And then we press the configurator button here. And then we will start to build our model code. Cylinders are configured by a model code where you select different options in terms of stroke length, mounting styles, oil connection, rod materials, and so on. And that is defined by a model code. And the model code will build or grow up here as we walk through the configuration.
Maybe we should stop for a second here. Mm-hmm. I just want to mention there has been a redesign of these configurators almost 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. Where we, let's say, switched from a typical click by click and page by page navigation into this more integrated way. Mm-hmm. I want to highlight that it's easier to go through, that it's faster.
Yep.
And especially for these options that we see here, they are always as good as possibly visualized. So
yes.
We did a research on this, and of course, pictures say more than 1,000 words. Mm-hmm. So we tried to do that. And also on the top side, there are some functionalities. There are some hidden functionalities. I mm-hmm. always call them the export or the really gold functions. Mm-hmm. We will talk about everything today.
Yep.
So let's maybe start with clicking through to this CDH1 version and show how easy it is.
Yep, absolutely. We'll do so. I would also just like to mention the go-to options that we have. You see the go-to symbol on the mounting styles in this case that are conform with the go-to program. As we scroll down here, see there are some mounting styles that are not go-to conform, and then there is no go-to symbol on those. In this case, we will select an MP5 mounting because that's what we have on our red cylinder next to me. It's a bore size diameter 40 millimeters combined with a rod diameter of 28 millimeters. The next step would be the stroke length, and in our case here we have 100 millimeters of stroke length. So in this case we could select anything from 1 millimeter up to 2,000 millimeters. So it's in 1 millimeter increments mm-hmm. that you can configure your stroke length. Next would be the oil connections. So we have different types of threads. And there's also flanged oil connections available as configurable standard options. Most common is the pipe thread, which is represented by the letter B. So we'll go with that one here. Next, we have to select on which position we want our oil connection, and here we have the possibility to select four different positions with 90 degrees increments, and we also have the possibility to have different positions mm-hmm. on the rear front and rear end. In our case, we want it on the top, so we select position one.
Mm-hmm.
Same on the rear end. Next will be the rod material. So for the CDH1, we have two different rod materials available as standard. So it's the hard chromium-plated rod, and it's also a case-hardened chromium-plated rod available.
Oh, I have an idea for a new task for you later on. So
okay.
Let's see.
It will be interesting. Let's see what we can do. Yeah. We'll go with the C option. Next step would be the rod thread. So you could have either the threaded rod, or you could have the rod I assembled already from the mm-hmm. in the delivery from the plant. In our case, we do not have a rod die assembled, so we go with the normal thread. And then we end up in the options regarding end position cushioning. And here we have different possibilities as well. You could have self-adjusting both ends. You could have adjustable cushioning, and you could have cushioning in just front or rear. So that's all standard and configurable.
Wait a second, Frederick. I mm-hmm. saw something that I already saw before. So if you scroll down again,
yep.
there was this area where there was an open box. Mm-hmm. And it's called an X.
Yep.
So what is this option X?
X means that in case you have a special need or a special request for something that is not available in the configurator, you could select the option X and you can type in what kind of modification you
okay.
would like us to do.
That's a very relevant thing
yep.
to know because mm-hmm. a normal configurator only offers what you have, always compared with the Lego pieces. You can
mm-hmm.
only build together what you have by Lego pieces, but
yep.
here you can define your own Lego piece.
Absolutely.
Violet, five corners,
yep.
only one button on top. So I think that's very interesting to know. You could make use out of the configuration process,
mm-hmm.
but still have an application based or in the individualization, which is close to the standard.
Yep.
And I think it will also save some time when you use this configuration
yep.
approach.
Absolutely.
And, I think that's very relevant to
yeah.
know.
So we can have a look into that later on,
mm-hmm.
But because then we of course go outside of the go-to scope.
Exactly.
So, but yeah. let's stick to
let's
the go-to.
Let's finish the standard for yep. a moment, yeah.
We select self-adjusting cushioning both ends. Next, we have to decide on a sealing system. What determines what kind of seals you need is, of course, your application in terms of could be temperature, in general environment, can be friction, what kind of fluid you need. In this case, we will go with the M option, which is yeah, by far the most common sealing system that we mm-hmm. normally manufacture our cylinders with. You have the possibility to select proximity switches. Today we go without, since that's not the go-to conform. Guide rings. We select without guide rings, and we
also here it's good to see that on the top left bottom,
mm-hmm.
so where you are already standing in
mm-hmm.
that area, there's the data sheet.
Yeah.
So you can always also have a look into the data sheet,
yeah.
and if you're not completely sure what one option means,
yes,
you can go there.
Absolutely. So the data sheet there is a direct link on
mm-hmm.
the left bottom left corner of the configuration
mm-hmm.
screen here.
Okay.
Test fittings. It's a possibility as well. Select without because we want to go to cylinder. Same with the grease fitting. And this is the piston rod prolongation option. You can have piston rod prolongation up to 1900 millimeters in our case, but we'll go without. And as we said in the beginning, we do not configure a red cylinder now,
mm-hmm.
but we will go with a standard blue one. So that's the Bosch Rexroth standard primer. And finally, we have two more options to finalize, and that's whether we want oil filling or not. We say no oil filling, and finally test certificate. We can have two different test certificates, 2.1 or 3.1. But again, then we're outside of the go-to scope. So in this case, we select without test certificate.
Well, that's it for the moment, right?
Yep, that concludes our configuration. So now we have on the top, you see the full model code, where we started with just the CDH1. We have now built our configuration, and we have letters and numbers in here to define what kind of cylinders that we...
So before we go into what's now offered, I think it was really obvious to see it was quite fast. I would say 2 minutes. If you maybe have to look some requirements or check and refine, maybe 5 minutes. But compared to the normal process, if you won't have this configurator, what will be the normal process until the customer gets like a documentation, a CAD drawing, like we will see in a second?
Yeah, I would say the normal time for that would be 1 to 2 working days.
Oh my God. Okay. Yeah, so
it's we save quite a lot of time.
Yeah, as you said, very massive time saving. And I just heard that we have some questions coming in. So before we will conclude now with the results here, so let's go back to the Q&A. Can we get drawings from the configurator? Okay, we will show in a second. Yep. Yes, the answer is yes, even 2D or 3D. And is it possible to supply the cylinder completely in stainless steel?
Basically, yes. It's of course not the standard product any longer. It's not configurable in the online configurator, but as an ETO cylinder, that is a possibility. Yes,
but it's already one. The extra task that I had in mind, at least the material for the piston rod. I would like to also urge you then to show how it's possible to make that on the configuration. So
absolutely,
in about 2 minutes, you will see how you can do that. In same application, we have to add the counterbalance value to control safely our cylinders. And advice about how identify this kind of items. Hope you get the point of the question. We have to add the counterbalance valve to control safely our cylinders. Do you have any advice how to identify this kind of item?
Well, it's not part of the. There's nowhere in the configurator that you can find this kind of information. That is something that we have to that has to be discussed and directly with the colleagues in at Bosch Rexroth.
So it's not a typical accessory.
No, it's not
something that you can definitely. Yeah, I think that's something you have to discuss with your sales representative based on your project, based on your application.
Yeah, and requirements obviously. Yes. So
I think there are some further questions. Let's have a look at them. Okay, we got that already. And I think the other one also. Okay, now switching back to the, thanks for your questions. It's really helpful to have that. Going back to the presentation, I think there's a lot that now is offered after the configuration. So maybe you can have a look at that.
Absolutely. So on the bottom of the screen here, you see we have a number of buttons which we can press for different type of information. And if we start with the product description, you will get basically a confirmation on the what you have selected during the configuration, the different options. We have to answer one of the questions here in the Mentimeter, we have a request CAD model, and here you can download both 3D and 2D dimensional drawing, and you can even select different types of CAD formats depending on what CAD system that you're using for the 3D model.
There's even the units, we have people coming in from US today.
Yep.
So it's also possible to have that one, the model, as well as the dimensional drawing in inches.
Absolutely, it is. And it's also possible to have the installation drawing in the American projection method as well. So there are a lot of different possibilities directly online.
We mentioned already accessories and spare parts, maybe some...
Yep, absolutely. We can have a look at that as well. I just want, before we do that, in order to be able to download the drawings and the CAD models, you have to enter an email address at the bottom here. And that will give you an email with a download link in the email. So, and that is an instant process. So it's just a matter of seconds, basically, before you have the...
So you don't have to wait for long?
No.
Okay.
So, accessories. Okay, so you could select the different types of accessories. One quite common is, of course, self-aligning clevis. So if I press that one, you have the possibility in this case. This is, of course, depending on the configuration, mm-hmm. but in the configurator will only show accessories that are compatible with the configuration that we sure. made. And in this case, we have two different raw dies available. We can select the CGAK, and then after that, so it's a kind of a mini configurator mm-hmm. for the accessories.
But I like it that it's attached to the original one.
Yes. Here you can select what type of grease fitting that you like, or if you want a maintenance-free bearing in the rod eye. Let's go with that type of grease fitting. And same thing here. You have a product description. You can also request a CAD model for the accessories.
For the accessory, yeah. And add it to the basket already. I saw it.
Yeah, and you can add it to your shopping basket as well. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Furthermore, we have a spare part button. If you press that one, you will see mm-hmm. what material number or article number, if you like, for the seal kit that is compatible with the configuration. So you have that directly.
Quite useful, because normally you also yes. order them directly.
Exactly, because what is worn down on the cylinder mm-hmm. is normally the seals. Of course, the cylinder itself will last for very long, but the parts that might have to be replaced is, of course, the seals. So. Mm-hmm. It's convenient to have that available here. You can order it directly at the same time as you order the cylinder.
And there's an expert function, I think the technical recalculation.
Yep.
We have seen there are some participants that are maybe know the configurator a little better.
Mm-hmm. So if you press the technical recalculation button, you have the possibility to enter some, let's say, input data or technical data, mm-hmm. and the system will then calculate some the capabilities of the cylinder in terms of cushioning capacity, buckling, safety factors.
And so you can iterate your selection
yeah.
and maybe adapt the changes.
Yeah, exactly.
So now let's say we want to buy it.
Mm-hmm.
How can we do that?
We add it to the shopping basket.
And before I want to buy it, I want to know the price.
Of course. So then we have to log in to the push the login button, and that will bring you to the logon page. And of course, now I'm a Bosch employee, so I will mm-hmm. press the login for Bosch employees.
But if it's a customer, they can apply if they don't have a
yep.
user.
Absolutely.
But otherwise, they will see the same like you are doing.
Yeah. So I log on. And then the system will calculate the gross price or a list price.
But for this individual version?
For this particular version here, yes. Yes. So in this case, we end up with 1,463 euros.
Okay.
As a list price.
And then if I put it into the basket, of course, I will get my discount.
Then you'll get your discount,
and
yes.
You will see the
net price, yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so I think that was the easy part now.
Yep.
To configure the standard one, you have to go to sign. That means, mm-hmm. what did you say, 15 days?
15 working days, yeah.
So about 2 weeks mm-hmm. delivery for mm-hmm. the standard blue one, but I said I would like to have it in red.
In red, yeah.
What should I do now? Should I restart now my configuration process?
No, that's not necessary. What you need to do is just go back to the position in the ordering code where you determine the color
mm-hmm.
or the paint. That is the position that is called color composition.
Okay.
So if I press there, this selections open up once more. Okay, so previously we selected the standard primer, and that is, yeah, like we mentioned, it's the blue color. If we want it in red, we have to go for the special paint. And then we have different corrosion protection categories, spanning from CP4 to CP7. And if you press the information button here, you will get the explanation on what the different categories mm-hmm. means in terms of corrosion resistance.
So you don't even have to look at the PDF
nope.
data sheet.
No, you can find the information directly here. So we'll go with the CP4 in this case. And next, it's of course the color tone.
And I don't have it right now.
No. I mean, the roll number is something that people normally maybe not know by heart,
mm-hmm.
But you know that you want a red cylinder, so therefore we have this possibility here to select red. And then when I click continue.
It's summertime, I like to have tomato red.
Tomato red, yeah. So now we have the selection of the different color tones in red. They're all numbers spanning from darker red to lighter red, of course. So you like the tomato red, so that's the 3013. And if you're not sure exactly what kind of color tone it is, you can press the information button here. So, okay, so now it's quite small here, but here you see the different roll numbers in the red category. Nice. Tomato red.
So now I'm leaving the standard, but should I now continue the configuration again, or is there any chance to speed this up?
Yeah, we're leaving the go-to program, but we're still within the standard configuration. Yes, we have a fast forward button here. So if we press that one,
it's a little hidden. So I think you have to know it, but once you know it, you will love it.
Yeah, that means that the system remembers the options that you made earlier, so that it just adds the red color to the other options that we previously selected.
It's interesting to see. So still a price information, of course, because as you said, it's part of the standard program, but no go-to icon.
Nope.
So. You will get it in the I think in the eShop you will get the estimated delivery time.
Yes, it's available there.
So, but we had this question already, and I also had this in mind with this option X. So, talking about stainless steel tie rod, piston rod.
Yeah. So that same procedure as for the with the colors. So we go to the position in the ordering code, which specifies the rod material. It's called piston rod version. We open up that position, and then we have the X possibility, like what you spoke about earlier. And here you can type in what your requirements are. In this case, we wanted a stainless steel piston rod, so we just type that in and click continue. And then once again, we will make use of the fast forward button to speed it up.
Well, I think at least this should answer part of the question that we had before, and we see now no price, no go-to, no add to basket.
Nope.
So that's why X outside of the standard, but still available for request. But how should I request now?
Yeah, then we have this button here, consultation request. So we press that one, and then a new window will open up where you can fill in your contact information. And then on the right-hand side here, you might have a Rexroth contact or a sales representative or something. Then you can tick this box here and then type in the email address of your Rexroth representative.
And as we have partners and salespeople also from Rexroth here, I think that's a very interesting feature to know. Maybe you haven't seen that before. If a customer is using the configurator and he's directly asking you on the phone, I want to have, or I have a question, or I want to order outside of the standard version. If he or she will put in your contact, you will be able to directly open it up. You will get a mail with the link, and you will see the same configuration like he has on the call, and you will be able to support him here very quickly, even maybe with a price if it's inside of the standard.
Yeah, absolutely. And if you don't have a Rexroth contact, you could just press the send button and the consultation request will end up at your local Rexroth order management
team. Depending on the zip code in the country.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so I think good to see that. But I still have a task.
Oh.
So we talked about this one now, and I also want to have this one.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I have a list maybe, and I already know the type code here.
Yeah.
So what should I do again, starting from scratch?
No. There's a shortcut for this as well. And that is one of the new things in the online configurator. So if you know your type code, if you have a cylinder, you can read it on your label, obviously. So now I prepared a type code here for the CDL2 cylinder, the blue one in the middle. Then I can just empty this space here and paste in the model code of the CDL2 cylinder.
So the good old copy and paste function.
Yes. And then the system will, based on that model code, will automatically generate the configuration. And you have the same possibilities here down here with the product description, the CAD models, accessories, and so on. And the price.
And now think about this, even took some seconds to get finally everything. Mm. So that's really amazing. And I could even manipulate the type code maybe to a different type of cylinder.
Yes. You could do that. You can, if you're not happy with a CDL2, you think you will need a CDT3, for example.
Mm-hmm.
Then you just edit the model code. Press
and
enter.
The system is smart enough to check what is available from the pre-settings that you had.
Yeah. And now you see we don't have the complete configuration here because the model code from the CDL2 and the CDT3 is slightly different. So the system basically stops at the position where there is a discrepancy between mm-hmm. the two model codes. So then you have to basically manually finalize the few options that remains.
Okay.
So in this case, it was basically two clicks and then we have our CDT3 configuration.
Frederick, that's really amazing. I think very great. Presentation here. I like to show because we have some 2 minutes left. Mm-hmm. Maybe a short look on the documentation because it's an incremental part of the outcome. As far as I understood, it's combining everything. It's combining the accessories list. It's combining the type code information, the dimensional drawings, a 3D PDF document. So everything that you would need, right?
Yep. Absolutely. So you could either.
Even changing the language over there.
Yeah.
And then you can directly send it also to your email or download it. And it will be generated in the background. Maybe mm-hmm. maybe it, in the PDF area, it's already there. But if not, you can open it up later.
Yeah.
You will have everything on hand.
Yes, absolutely.
So thanks for this. I think mm-hmm. well done. You managed to do all the tasks.
Yeah. Thank you.
Let's go back to the Q&A for a second to have a look if there's anything coming in. No further questions. I think it was quite mm-hmm. quite appropriate. So as we said, the presentation will be sent out to the participants by mail.
Mm-hmm.
But I think you also have some information there on what you can find online.
Yeah, absolutely. So in case you need some further information, we have a...
maybe you can show the other page.
Now I have a problem with the
okay.
with the PowerPoint. But anyway, there is a website called boschrexroth.com/cylinders where further information is available. You can find the configurator there. You can find some movies. You can mm-hmm. find a white paper, product data sheets, and other things.
And of course, if you have questions or a project or an application. First contact will be the local sales office. You may know already your sales representative, or if you're a partner, your partner manager. Mm-hmm. But of course, Frederick's also there. So he's a modern engineer, so he's available mm-hmm. on LinkedIn.
Yep.
So if you have some specific questions that nobody can answer, he will be there answering your questions, I think, as good as possible. Right?
Absolutely.
And that's it from us, from your side. So mm-hmm. thanks again for this really, really good impression mm-hmm. and very well done work here on the configuration of the mm-hmm. cylinders here.
Thank you.
Let's go back maybe a second to your feedback. So I would like to urge you to fill this feedback. And while you're doing this, I would take the chance to say thank you for your participation today. We will have the next web seminar on the 22nd of June concerning our offering Citro Connect, which makes it easier for you to minimize your downtime. So there will be my colleague Michael Herrlein showing you a little bit more about Citro Connect. So thanks again for your participation and your feedback, and stay safe. Talk to you and see you soon. Bye-bye.